What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to mine Dynex. Seems to be some issues going amongst the community, so hopefully this video will get you up and running. Now, why would you want to mine Dynex? Looking at this, in the past 1 year, it's actually up 681.3%. That's some pretty nice gains there. Moving into mining pool stats of the top 10 here, we can see Dynex is actually in 7th place, raking in about $127,000 that is paying for security to secure its network. That is 7th place of the top coins and the number one coin for GPUs right now in terms of those emissions. Jumping in, and it looks like GPU miners are actually taking notice that HiveOS, one of the most popular operating systems for crypto mining, majority of the people using it is mining Dynex. So Dynex is gaining a lot of popularity. I do want to give a big shout out to Hero Miners for sponsoring this video and showing you how to set up Dynex for their pool. They recently added Dynex to their mining pool section, and they're also giving away some free money. So 1,000 USD Hero Miners airdrop and a 0% pool fee. Fee-free mining. We wish to inform you that to celebrate the launch of our Dynex mining pool, we'll airdrop 1,000 USD total to 6 different Hero Miners Dynex miners. The airdrop levels are as follows: $500 to one single miner and $100 to 5 miners. There is no hash rate requirement or restrictions. Everyone is equal here. To participate, all you need to do is mine in the Dynex Hero Miners pool. You don't need to register. Any wallet address can enter up to 5 times, as there will be 5 snapshots of actively mining addresses made at the pool at disclosed dates. Therefore, the earlier one enters, the more chances they get. So that means get on the pool ASAP if you want the chance at the most amount of draws. When 4 snapshots are made, the announcement will be made stating that there's still 1 snapshot left. It's disallowed to enter the giveaway with multiple addresses, and anyone who violates this rule will be removed from the giveaway with a notice. The amount will be converted at the time of payment to Dynex and paid out in crypto. The 5 snapshots will be taken at regular intervals from August 8th to August 31st, so for the rest of this month. The winning wallet addresses will be chosen randomly using a random number generator by a third party, video recorded specifically by Seb from Seb FinTech. Here is the link to Seb's channel. I'm sure you guys all know him. I will have that down in the description as well. And 1,000 USD worth of Dynex will be purchased and distributed to the winning wallet addresses shortly after they're known. What's more, mining at Hero Miners Dynex pool and solo will be completely fee-free until August 31st. No reward fees, no payout fees, no any kind of fees. So there's zero fees happening across the pool, as well as this 1,000 USD giveaway, depending on the snapshots and get in there. So head on over to Hero Miners and start mining Dynex today. So the first thing you are going to need with any coin is a wallet. So I will have links to anything I mentioned in this video down in the description, but you come to Dynex's main website here, dynexcoin.org, and click on get. Then you're going to scroll down till you do see anything that starts mentioning wallets. And here we do see Dynex wallets. Originally, when Dynex first released, all you had was the web wallet. Now, I never like any web wallets. I don't like them at all, but they do have a GUI wallet, a CLI wallet, and all sorts of wallets happening. So they do have multiple wallets available. So that's pretty sweet. Scroll down a bit more, and here is the download link for the GUI wallet. Just download that, install it, set it up, and copy your receiving address, and you should be good to go. So for finding some tuning for your GPUs in terms of overclock settings, I would suggest starting at hashrate.no, look up the GPU you have, go to Dynex, and you can see here they have core clock offset of 300, you can lock your core clock at 1455, and a memory clock lock at 5000, power limit of 150, and you should be running around these numbers. Their numbers tend to be a bit off. I don't know if they're just running software numbers or what. The wall will be a little bit higher than what it's showing here, but it's a nice baseline just to kind of go off of and then kind of do your tweaking from there. I do plan on checking some nice efficient settings and testing some GPUs out for this sometime in the future, but for now, this is a nice baseline just to kind of get you off your feet. All right, so now I'm going to show you guys how to set up your miner in Windows. And depending on the hardware you're using will determine on the miner you need. Now in my workstation, all I have is an RTX 3090. So I'm going to have to use 1.0 miner. If you're on AMD, you're going to have to use SRB miner, because due to the latest updates, SRB miner actually removed temporarily removed Nvidia support. So they only support AMD right now. So we're going to have to rock 1.0 miner. And if you're on AMD, use SRB miner and so on. So you kind of see what's going on there. But I'm going to be setting this up in Windows on 1.0 miner. So the first thing you do here is obviously download the miner, 1.0 miner, Win64, 1.2.2 zip. All right, so once you do get that extracted, you will have this here. You may have to add a little configuration to your Windows antivirus because it's probably going to flag it as virus or bad malware or something. So just allow it to go through. From that point on, you'll have this little file here called mine. I have this at stock here so that you can see me do it right from scratch. And this is what will come up. So first thing we're going to do here is remove our worker name and address right here. It doesn't have my worker name in it, but that is our worker address. So we're going to paste our address in there. Then I'm simply going to go .rabidws. So that will be my worker name. Next, we got to choose our pool. Now here you can see it's defaulting to NeuroPool as well as deep miners. This comma in between is adding like your backup pool. Now a lot of people like to add backup pools. It's a good idea if your main pool goes down, but I find with anything, I only use one pool. If it goes down, it goes down. I do check my rigs quite often, so I'm just going to wipe this out completely. And I'm going to do the same thing for the mallob endpoint here. I'm going to wipe this one out completely as well. So we're going to go right to here. There we go. So now we have, you can see our, where we're going to go right here. This is going to be our pool, and this is going to be our endpoint. So now we need our pool. And our, to find that, we simply go into Hero Miners right here. I'm going to use... let's see, where is North American West? So we're going to copy this. Now there's a little extra step here. If you go to the top here, you can see mallob port. So here's an example. It's 1119. Here's the example if you're on DE. So you can see this. So I'm going to actually use this exact same thing I just copied. But for the mallob endpoint, I'm actually going to swap the 1120 to 119. You'll see what I'm talking about in a minute here. So if I bring this back up here, we're coming into here. Bam, now here's our mallob endpoint. I'm going to put the exact same thing in, but remove the port. And this is where I'm going to put in the 1119. So 1119. And that's pretty much it. From there, I'm just going to save it. Save that, close it out, and we should be able to run our miner, and it should connect just fine. Now at this point, once you have it saved, we're just going to double click on mine. I'm just going to edit it so you can see it's, I didn't do anything here. It's exactly the same that I just did. We close it out, double click, and we should connect to our mallob endpoints, a server, everything here. We can see trying to register the mallob server, successful, everything's good. Now it's just going to take a few seconds and it will in fact begin mining. So setting up Dynex is fairly easy. There is that extra mallob port endpoint, and I find, I don't know, a lot of you guys seem to be having issues. I don't know if it has to do with the dual pools or you accidentally got rid of the comma or put an extra comma or a little space. I just wipe out everything completely and use one pool. I find that makes everything a lot easier. So it did take a couple minutes to finally get everything loaded up and ready to go, but you can see we are now rocking a new job in here. We got the pools all connected. We got some hash rate. We're getting accepted shares. So everything is working as it should. I don't have any overclocking going in whatsoever. As you can see, 350 watts. We'll kind of look at overclocking later on. You know, I don't really know the best overclock settings. I suggest going to hashrate.no. But for now, you know, this is how you get set up, and it's pretty easy to start mining Dynex. All right, so we are in HiveOS now, so I'm going to show you how to set this up. I got my test bench here all set up with an RTX 3070, so we're going to come into my GPU CPU farm, simply go to flight sheets, and then here is our coin. So for coin, we're just going to go DNX. It should be in here right there, so click that obviously. Now pick your wallet. Mine is Dynex. If you don't yet have a wallet, all you got to do is simply click on add wallet right here. Select Dynex, which it already is. Paste your address into here and then name it whatever you want and then hit the create. It's a pretty simple process. So once you do that, your wallet will pick up in here. As for pool, Hero Miners is new, so it is not in the list. So you're going to have to scroll down to configure in miner. At that point, we are going to select one. I'm just going to type it in here, one. And you can see 1.0 miner will pop up. I can do a quick name here, DNX Hero. And then we're going to go set up miner config. So here it already has the hash algorithm as Dynex wallet template. We're going to go wallet, put a period here. and then just go down and hit wallet worker name again. So here's worker name. So we got wallet period worker name. This will pull your HiveOS wallet that you have configured in your flight sheet, as well as your HiveOS worker name is kind of what's going on here. For pool URL, this is where we go back into the mining pool here, and we're going to copy North American West. Use the closest stratum to you. I'm going to copy that over. And again, we're going to need that port 1119 for that mallob endpoint when we get to it. So now I'm going to put in the pool URL. So this is where our mallob endpoint is going to go in the extra config argument. Simply highlight over this, put in the mallob endpoint, and then go space, paste in exactly what we just had here for our pool URL. But we're going to go back and use that 1119 just to double check and confirm. Three ones and a nine here. Let's go back in. Three ones and a nine. Everything looks good. We're going to apply those changes. Dynex hero. Hit create flight sheet, and now we're just going to go into our test bench mining rig or whatever rig you are going to use for this. We're going to hit the flight sheet. We're going to find our latest flight sheet here, or if you want to quickly find it, if you have a whole bunch, you can go to more coins and then just find Dynex, and you can see it'll pop up first here. 10 miner, what we just named it. This is our flight sheet. Send that to the moon by hitting the rocket ship. Now I'm simply going to do a quick remote access Hive Shell start, and then this will give us access into it where we can begin watching everything kind of mine and stuff, well, instead of waiting for the dashboard to start giving you some hash rates. So I think that'll be the easiest way to show you guys that this is actually working and nothing crazy going on there. So sometimes it takes a minute, you know, it's taking its sweet time. There we go. Hive Shell is in there. Now click on this. It's going to load the Hive Shell just like you normally would from doing your normal remote access. For some reason with my internet, it's not letting me, so I have to use the shell. But now we're just going to put in miner. And now you can see it's loading everything up. We got our worker wallet address. We successfully registered with Mallob server and our address. So everything's looking good. We're finding shares. We are now up and mining Dynex and HiveOS with Nvidia GPUs on 10 miner, just like Windows. It's a really easy process. And hopefully this is making it a little bit easier for you guys to understand. Okay, so we're still in HiveOS here, and I threw in an AMD GPU, not just any AMD GPU, a classic, the RX 580. So I'm going to show you how to set this up with AMD and SRB miner. So first we're going to go into our flight sheets, just like our Nvidia tutorial here. Type coin and ticker. We're going to go Dynex. It should bring up Dynex right here, first on the list, obviously. Wallet. Now, if you don't have a wallet, simply click add wallet. Put in your address right here and then name it whatever you would like. If once you do that, it will pop up. We got Dynex and select pool. Again, Hero Miners is new, so you're going to have to pick configure in miner. And then we're going to choose SRB miner. So we're going to click on that. I am going to name this, I guess, Dynex Hero AMD. So that's pretty easy to realize what we're using there. We're going to go up setup miner config. We're going to need our wallet. And then our worker name. So we're going to put that in here. I don't know. I usually find that it bugs out if you actually put the worker name here. So we're going to cut that out, put a period, and then paste that in right there. Now we're going to need our server port. So remember, we go back into the pool here. We're going to copy our, use the closest stratum to you. And then we're going to have to remember the 1119 for our mallob endpoint. So first we're going to start with this. We're going to come in, we're going to paste that in, and then we're going to paste it again right away in the plugin and device config. So we're going to paste that in there, and we're going to adjust that to the 1119 port. Now, we're going to need the intro part to this as well, the beginning. So in order to do that, I actually extracted a previous version of SRB miner, and this is what it does look like. So you're going to come into here and copy this part right here. So we're going to copy that just to show you I'm in SRB miner. That's what I did here. I extracted a brand new version instead of running through a whole bunch of configs. Did the Dynex start bat file here and just copy their command that they have in the Windows version. And we're going to paste that right in front of it. Make sure there's a space right here. You don't want two spaces like this or something or any comma or anything else. You just paste that in exactly one space and then that mallob endpoint of the IP here of 1119 at the end. So that is all we really need to do. We're going to apply our changes. We have our name and everything in, create that flight sheet. We're going to come back into our miner worker config here. So we're going to our workers. We're going to scroll down to our test bench. We're going to go to flight sheet. And now go to our coins here, find Dynex. And we can see Dynex Hero AMD, which is what we just made. We're going to hit the rocket ship, send that to the moon, and now we're going to kind of hive shell into this again, just like we did with Nvidia, and begin mining. We should be able to see the mining process boot up, and if we did everything right, it should be looking good with a bunch of accepted and green and connections and stuff happening there. So again, it's taking its sweet time. So it takes a couple seconds sometimes, guys. Be patient. Hang in there. There we go. So we're going to click on that, and now we should see if we actually set this up correctly. Don't worry. I already know we did. You know, I know what I'm doing here most of the time. Sometimes I don't. So now we're going to put in miner, and now we can see that we are using the Hero Miner's mallob endpoint. We can see we updated our capacity. It's doing its thing. It's connected to Hero Miner's pool. Now we just got to wait for everything to fully load, and we will begin mining. And we have our first accepted share, a little bit of hash rate happening here. So there we go, guys. We are all both set up and mining on AMD GPUs, Nvidia GPUs, all sorts of GPUs, Windows and HiveOS. All right, guys. So there we go. You should be up and running in Windows with Nvidia and AMD and Nvidia in HiveOS. Hopefully this video did help you out. I know a lot of you guys were having quite a bit of issues with that mallob endpoint and not being to set it up right. I don't know what the issue was, but remember, I just like running single pools. Everything seems to work fine. It is fast and easy if you got everything in the correct spots. Let me know if this video helped you out at all. And remember, Hero Miners has a 1000 USD giveaway and 0% pool fees to the end of the month. Head on over to their pool and start mining Dynex today. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.